हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज़ प्रोफेसर शशिकांत लामकानी, वर्किंग एज असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग ऑफ एन बीनवले सिंहगढ़ कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग, केगांव सोलापुर। आई एम हैविंग 11 ईयर्स ऑफ टीचिंग एक्सपीरियंस एंड 1.5 ईयर्स ऑफ इंडस्ट्रियल एक्सपीरियंस। आई हैव कम्प्लीटेड माई पोस्ट ग्रेजुएशन विथ अ मैकेनिकल डिज़ाइन इंजीनियरिंग। सो टूडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस इन दिस वीडियो, दैट इज़ यूनिट नंबर 8 ऑफ काइनेमेटिक्स एंड थेरी ऑफ मशीन्स सब्जेक्ट, एंड द नेम ऑफ यूनिट इज अ बैलेंसिंग। सो इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू फोकस ऑन इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ बैलेंसिंग। सो बिफोर मूविंग टू एक्चुअल वीडियो, सो वी आर गोइंग टू सी वॉट आर द डिफरेंट कंटेंट्स वी आर गोइंग टू कवर इन दिस यूनिट, यूनिट नंबर 8। So the contents are static and dynamic balancing of rotary masses and balancing of single cylinder engines. So under these there are several types, so which are going to see in detail in a further video. So then we are going to move towards the introduction of the balancing. So it is very essential that all the rotating and reciprocating part should be completely balanced. Okay, so the first thing, all rotating and reciprocating part should be completely balanced as far as possible. So if these parts are not properly balanced, then the dynamic forces are set up. These forces not only increase the load on bearing, so this is the first effect of unbalanced system. Unbalanced system means the system which is not having the proper balancing or completely balanced. Then the first effect is load on bearings and stresses in a various member. So along with this, so first effect is a load on bearings and stresses in a various member. So along with this, it produces the unpleasant and even dangerous vibrations. So it means that if any rotary or reciprocating part is not properly balanced, then effect of this is there is a load on bearings. So first effect, along with this, the stresses are developed in a various member, and also there is a producing the unpleasant and dangerous vibration. So that's why the rotating and reciprocating part should be completely balanced as far as possible to minimize the load and stresses on bearing and various part, along with the minimizing the vibration. So in this unit we are going to discuss the balancing of unbalanced force causes by rotating masses in order to minimize the pressure on the main bearings when the engine is going to run. Okay, now we are going to focus firstly in this unit the balancing of rotating masses. Okay, so what is the meaning of balancing of rotating masses we are going to discuss. Whenever certain mass is attached to rotating shaft, it exerts some centrifugal force. So consider that there is a one shaft. On the shaft there is a one mass added or connected to that shaft. Okay, so when this shaft is going to rotate, then there is a generation of centrifugal force whose effect is to bend the shaft and produce the vibration in it. So because of this centrifugal force, the shaft may get bent or the production of वाइब्रेशन. सो इन ऑर्डर टू प्रिवेंट द इफेक्ट ऑफ सेंट्रीफ्यूगल फोर्स अनदर मास इज अटैच टू अपोजिट साइड ऑफ द शाफ्ट. इट मीन्स दैट टू मिनिमाइज द इफेक्ट ऑफ सेंट्रीफ्यूगल फोर्स सो वी आर गोइंग टू एड वन मोर डमी मास अपोजिट टू द फर्स्ट मास अपोजिट टू द फर्स्ट मास ओके एट सच अ पोजिशन सो सच अ पोजिशन सो एज टू बैलेंस द इफेक्ट ऑफ सेंट्रीफ्यूगल फोर्स ऑफ फर्स्ट मास मीन्स फॉर मिनिमाइजिंग द इफेक्ट ऑफ सेंट्रीफ्यूगल फोर्स ऑफ फर्स्ट मास वी आर गोइंग टू एड वन मोर मास अपोजिट टू द फर्स्ट मास एंड विच इज गोइंग टू रिड्यूस द इफेक्ट ऑफ सेंट्रीफ्यूगल फोर्स ऑफ फर्स्ट मास सो दिस इज डन इन सच अ वे दैट द सेंट्रीफ्यूगल फोर्स ऑफ बोथ मासेस आर मेड टू बी इक्वल एंड अपोजिट ओके द प्रोसेस ऑफ प्रोवाइडिंग द सेकेंड मास इन ऑर्डर टू काउंट्रैक्ट द इफेक्ट काउंट्रैक्ट द इफेक्ट मीन्स मिनिमाइज और रिड्यूस द इफेक्ट ऑफ सेंट्रीफ्यूगल फोर्स ऑफ फर्स्ट मास इज कॉल्ड एज बैलेंसिंग ऑफ रोटेटिंग मासेस सो दिस इज द प्रोसेस सो बैलेंसिंग इज द प्रोसेस टू मिनिमाइज द सेंट्रीफ्यूगल फोर्स ऑफ फर्स्ट मास बाय एडिंग द डमी मास अपोजिट टू द फर्स्ट मास सो फॉर दिस पर्पज वी आर गोइंग टू सी वन वीडियो इन विच there is a setup to understand the balancing of rotary masses. So, in this video, we are going to see the setup for balancing. So, by you seeing this video, we are able to understand how the system get unbalanced and how we are going to make the system balanced. Now in this system there is a one shaft which is a rotary one. So this shaft is mounted on a two bearings with a two support. Okay. So this shaft is having four connectors 1, 2, 3, and 4. On each connector there is a space for provision of mass. Now in this case if we are going to remove the masses of these two okay if you see these two are having same angle so when these two are having same angle so to counteract to minimize the centrifugal force of these two masses we are going to add two more masses in opposite direction okay if you we see the angle of these two is similar and angle of these two is opposite to these two masses now if we are going to remove the masses of these two connectors and keep the masses of these two connectors then this system is unbalanced okay so this we will see practically so this is about the construction so see here so all the four connectors are having masses so this nut these nuts are act as a masses so 1, 2, 3, 4 now this system is balanced because for counteract the effect of these two masses we are going to add two more masses in a opposite direction so whatever the effect generated by these two masses or these two masses is counteract or minimized by the opposite one okay so this we will see practically so see here the two masses are removed from this point and two masses are present over here now this system is unbalanced when we are going to start this setup okay so start this setup this unbalanced setup so you will see the vibration in the complete system Okay, so complete system is vibrated because of the unbalanced system. And why this system is unbalanced? Because the two masses are removed from this case. Okay, so see over here. So two masses are removed from this system. So because of this system get unbalanced and see the vibration. So after adding masses or dummy masses to counteract the effect or counteract the effect of centrifugal force, now these two masses are added. Now see, after starting this system, the vibrations are going to reduce. So see the system vibrations. So we will visualize. So at this location, so the vibration is minimized. Okay, so this is the concept or the theoretical concept is converted into practical apparatus like the Lab Innovations project. Now we are going to see the actual industrial example. So this setup is used to check the balancing of the fan, plastic fan blade. So here there is a RPM of the system, here the unbalanced force. Okay, and when we are going to see the part is, in this case, this is the fan blade. This fan blade is mounted on the setup. After mounting this fan on the setup, so there is a starting of this motor. Because of this, this fan is going to rotate with a near about 900 something RPM, and 3.4 or 3.5 is the unbalanced force. So this system will showing this person at which location you supposed to add the mass. So this system is going to show CD. At this location there is a mounting of the or adding of the mass. So he is going to add some mass at this location. So after adding the mass at this location and after checking on the setup, now see, for the same RPM, so there is a reduction of unbalanced force. So this is come about the 0.2, and in previous case it is become a 3.5. so unbalanced force is going to reduce. So such a way that in industry there is a checking of every rotary or reciprocating member for the balancing, and such a way that they are going to add the masses to minimize the effect of unbalanced forces. So this is about the concept of balancing of the thing. Then next we are going to see there are several cases. So in this video we are going to see in a detail. So several cases of balancing of rotary mass. So first case is balancing of single mass rotating in a same plane. Means in this first case, if we want to balance the single rotating mass, for that purpose we are going to use the single mass rotating in a same plane. So by such method we are able to balance the system. So in next case, balancing of single rotating mass by two masses rotating in a different plane. Means in first case we are going to use single dummy mass to balance the system. In this case we are going to use two masses to balance the system. Okay, then third one is balancing of different masses rotating in a same plane. So first two cases are of single rotating mass, and third case is of different masses rotating in same plane. Means more than one masses when occurs, then we are going to balance the system. We are going to see how we are going to balance the system. We are going to see in this case. And the last case is balancing of different masses rotating in a different plane. So these all four cases we are going to see thoroughly in a next video. So one by one we are going to see the theoretical part of each case and the problems on it. So thank you.